Welcome back, this is Slim Cognito, and we're playing Breathedge. This will be a complete walkthrough of Chapter 1.
Greetings, I'm your funerary spacesuit's built-in guide to the world of space funerals. Before we start communicating further, confirm that you are still able to read after the impact. Splendid! You've gotten into a non-standard situation. The Breathedge Global Funeral Agency is proud of its impeccable history. However, your death may cause the loss of its reputation. Therefore, we suggest that you stop the gas leak and survive. When picking up any useful items, you can stuff them in your pockets, calling it an inventory, if you will. Take out the chewing gum from your pocket. Try not to get your funerary, stick it somewhere except for your face. You deserve some words of encouragement. That's impressive. You've almost won. Remember that the funerary spacesuit isn't designed for long-term use of persons or animals in outer space. It is recommended to immediately call for help on the interphone. Improve the spacesuit, adjust the antenna, you'll have to go into outer space. When you discover a new blueprint of an item, it is automatically added to the memory reprocessor in the kitchen, where you can create this item using the necessary resources, probably. A source of increased radiation is detected. Probably this is the central core of the liner. Be careful, the radiation will kill you instantly in such a suit. That was a close call. Try to adjust the antenna very carefully. You've got great engineering skills. You have broken the antenna completely. Now you will need some special equipment and interphone activation codes, which are encrypted in the... It looks like the steering wheel. You need to try to... Great news! Using my ingenious two-digit password matching algorithm, I managed to hack the interphone activation codes. Now all that's left is to build a... Remember that you are still able to become depressed. Judging by the primary analysis of the destruction, most of the passengers of the liner died. This might be the biggest catastrophe in the history of astronautics, the reasons for which are yet to be clarified. If you're sure that this is exactly what was on the blueprint, then try to reconfigure the receiver. If you have any doubts concerning it, then you will eventually suffer an electric shock, and then your spacesuit will automatically take your body measurements to order a coffin from our company. Thank you for choosing the Global Funeral Agency. The rescuer's arrival time exceeds your estimated lifespan by 4,369 years. You need to get to the extraction point yourself, getting past the radiation. However, it's impossible to do this with your current skills. To increase your level, you need to create some craft imposed by the developers. It wasn't possible to determine the coordinates of the survivor. Communication only works on reception, which gives a good reason not to respond and not to be distracted, despite the objections of the hormonal system.
Bye.
Your interlocutor has a very sweet accent, causing fatal errors in my grammatical functions. The electrical stimulation is complete. Having traced your brain's activity while you were working, your brain was stimulated with small electrical charges to improve your engineering skills. Judging by the result, it didn't work and caused a number of hallucinations. However, it was entertaining. You still can't get past the radiation, but I will mark the coordinates of the rescuers for useless motivation. Judging by the degree of decomposition, this subject died long before the catastrophe. We have a murder here, Sherlock, and it is unlikely that he suffocated from this, being in a spacesuit where oxygen is sufficient for an entire full breath. The largest condom in the world, and also an emission of gas, most likely oxygen, are detected ahead. There's no data on the condom being suitable for an oxygen reservoir, but you can try to construct a simple balloon for distracting yourself from fatal thoughts. The service supply compartment. Almost intact. They usually install oxygen stations here. You would be a damaged door scanner. You can scan the scanner with a scanner to record the scanner's damage data to the scanner's scanner protection system for emergency depressurization of the compartment. You will need a scanner. I used the word scanner 8 times. Thank you. Be careful with the vacuum breakdowns. An electric shock of such power can lead to the failure of my systems, and I can't guarantee the safety of your corpse before the arrival of the funeral team. A model from the advertisement of the Global Funeral Agency. She looks good even without her head, but I wouldn't recommend touching the picture, as it could be regarded as sexual harassment. There can be no mistake here. This is working autonomous oxygen station. You must carefully remove the station by removing two screws. Anyway, this doesn't matter anymore. At least now you have an understanding of how to assemble one. You have a set of its parts and a light taste of despair. The sensors report the presence of some nearby cooling gel. Its microscopic particles can settle. Toilet detected. Some of our clients are very sensitive about toilet talk, and therefore we included a dictionary filter which will replace the word feces with the word joy. Depressurization may occur in the vicinity of the toilet pump when the waste tanks are damaged externally. It is highly recommended not to sit on it during such moments. The waste disposal system is damaged and is operating in reverse mode. The toilet can suck objects flying past the shuttle when the tanks are full. Judging by the amount of joy around, this is the debris of the liner's public toilet. This means that there may be large reserves of water from the shower tanks nearby. The main thing is not to confuse them with liquid waste tanks. The shuttle was flooded with paint during the crash. Even the service center wouldn't be able to clean it from the inside. It's impossible to repair it. The paint itself also has no value after freezing. It's probably the owner of the shuttle with paint. He was engaged in illegal pumping during the crash, judging by the traces of paint on his hands and a huge hose stuck to his face. If this station doesn't explode, your engineering skills will be reconsidered. I recommend that you investigate the immediate vicinity in search of radiation protective equipment for flying to the evacuation zone. The safe is private property, and the Global Funeral Agency is indifferent to the fact of its opening. The Breathedge Global Funeral Agency. We care about your reputation. A large accumulation of toxic colorant has been discovered. If you find a container with this substance, you may receive irreversible brain damage and also improve the anti-radiation protection of the spacesuit. It looks like a tank with paint. The shuttle got caught in some larger debris. Lucky.
Thank you.
A cemetery of rescue shuttles. The evacuation zone is very close, but the amount of debris is far from encouraging. It is highly recommended that you not touch the glass fragments with your hands. Tiny splinters are able to pierce the thin fabric of the spacesuit and cause a slight death attack. The shuttle's plating is blue. These are the rescuers. Given that the evacuation shuttles have increased strength, the impact force must have been incredible. The rescuer spacesuits are like funerary ones, but I always wanted to learn how their flashlights work as they don't require recharging. I propose we loot the corpse for scientific purposes. Due to the high toxicity level of the renewed painting of the spacesuit, the probability of your death from radiation is now lower than the probability of death from the suit itself. In this regard, you can fly to the evacuation point.
Thank you.
The presence of such an amount of cooling gel is strange. Such a composition was outdated more than 10 years ago and is not produced on any planet. The captain's bridge is detected ahead. The evacuation should be led from there, but there are no signals or movement detected in this area. Probably everyone died. With such an accent, the incorrect localization sounds extremely convincing. The information on the captain's bridge is classified in the database, therefore it is recommended to ignore this valuable advice and act according to the situation. The captain's bridge was badly damaged, but the main systems are still functioning properly. The door is locked. If you manage to get inside, there is a chance to send a distress signal to the nearest planet, or at least take the course with the captain who allowed this to happen. Seems it will be a long day.